You might have heard, probably from the likes of me, that you can predict exactly where the Aether is using the name of your first guide, dungeon bricks, glowing moss, and the materials jungle shrines are made of. And yes, this is true. The vast majority of the time, you can pinpoint Aether locations near exactly using these seemingly unrelated variables. For most worlds, the guide's name corresponds exactly to the Aether's horizontal position. Dungeon bricks are the same, but since there are only three options, it is much less precise. Meanwhile, the jungle shrines and moss are similar. Each of the five colors corresponds to a certain range of the depth of the Aether biome. The question here is then, why? Of all things, why is the Aether spawn location related to the guide's name, dungeon color, moss, and jungle shrines? I mean, they're wholly unrelated features released at completely different times. If it was intentional, it would probably be the weirdest feature in the entire game. Well, it isn't intentional. Red's not that high. It just happens to be a quirk of how randomness is executed in Terraria, or rather, when it isn't. You see, computers are deterministic machines. The clanker only does what it is told, and as such, it can't actually produce true randomness. It can produce things that seem random, but that randomness is always determined based on something. That something is the quote, seed. Based on a given seed, a pseudo-random algorithm will produce a sequence of seemingly random numbers. Given the same seed, a pseudorandom algorithm will always create the same sequence of numbers. Normally, we try to choose a seed that is as random as possible, usually from sources of entropy like user input or even the environment, so that our sequence is as random as possible, but when we want a predetermined, random series of numbers, we can actually control that by choosing our seed. That's what the Terraria World Seed is. It's the physical number we pass on to the randomness function that generates all the randomness for the world. The same seed will produce the same series of numbers for the world gen to use as it generates the world, and as such, it will produce the same world. You know all those words that flash on screen as you generate a world, describing all the processes the world generator is going through? Well, those are indicative of the passes the generator does to create the world. The entire world generation process is done as a series of generation passes, of which there are a lot. The peculiar thing with this is that each pass is run kinda independently from each other. As such, instead of using like one random number generator for the whole process that everyone uses, it so happens that each pass is actually given its own instance of the same random number generator. So what does this have to do with anything? Or remember how two random number generators with the same seed will produce the same sequence of numbers? Since each pass has its own random number generator, each pass gets the same sequence of numbers to work with within each pass. The first random number each pass asks for will always be the same as the first random number any other pass asks for, and the second random numbers across all passes will be the same, and the third, and the fourth, and so on and on. This means if we can figure out one of the random numbers in this sequence from some source, we can actually predict a ton of the other world gen from each pass, given that they use the same number in sequence. As an example, let's go back to our guide names in the Aether. We can see that when the guide's name is chosen, it's the second time the game asks for a random number in that pass. Then, looking at the Aether's code, we can see that the code that chooses the Aether's horizontal position is also the second time the game asks for a random number in its pass. This means the random numbers they use should be the same. Now, since it is very easy to find out what the guide's name is, and since we know which guide names correspond to which values the random number generator spits out, we can use the guide's name to figure out what the random value behind this is. Then, since we know the random value for the Aether is the same as the guide's, we can apply this value to find out the Aether's unknown location, and kablamo! There it is! As long as we know two things use the same random number when they are generated, we can relate the two. And if we can find out one, we can figure out things about the other that we previously didn't know. As some examples, both the jungle shrine materials and glowing moss color use the same random number, the first one, and so does the depth of the Aether, so that's why we can use these two to find out that. The location of the sky island with the red balloon also uses the first number, so it's related to these three as well, as is the number of sand dunes, and thus pyramids, as well as the depth of the first chest in the dungeon. Despite only being generated in hard mode, the hard mode V-strip of evil is also related to all these random values, since it also initializes a new random number generator with the seed at the start of hard mode. The first and second values apparently correlate with the location of the V-strips, and the third value relates to the side the corruption spawns on. This does mean that the direction of the wind when you first load up a world should tell you which side will be evil upon the start of hard mode, although apparently this method isn't extremely reliable. The jungle temple's location is also based off the first and second random values, just like the Aether, but because of how picky it is a generation, it almost always needs multiple tries to generate, meaning this method is extremely unreliable. In practice, this means it is not possible to determine the location of a jungle temple unlike the Aether, which is quite annoying. So, basically, as a recap, since the RNG's random number output is deterministic based on the seed, and since Terraria uses a new instance of the same RNG for each generation pass, meaning they each use the same sequence of random numbers, we can relate features from any one pass to features from any other pass, given we know they use the same random number from the sequence. It makes seemingly unrelated things connect in very interesting ways. So far from what I can tell, most of the research into this has come from the speedrunning community, and they were who gave me the information on this all the way back in 2023 when I made my video on finding the Aether. So, credits to them here. For now, for most people, the best application of this knowledge is probably finding the Aether. Certainly, it beats digging for it yourself. Hello, if you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing as only a third of y'all are. Similar videos are on the left and right. Either way though, thank you for watching, and good day, and goodbye. See you next week.